Now let's see what happens when we use a rank 2 approximation. What does that mean? Well, we saw how to project onto the span of A, and we went through the math of what it means to project onto the column space of a matrix A. What if we now take that matrix A to consist of two columns, and in this example, we're picking it to be the first column and a column in the middle. So then our matrix A has two columns, which we picked to be columns from our picture, namely the first column and a column in the middle. What happens if we project the first column in B onto the column space of A? Well, A is just B0, and therefore we better get back our vector A. So the first column of the approximate picture is going to be exactly the column in the original picture. If we scoot over slightly, then we have a column that's very similar to A, so we would expect to get a result very similar to A, where you could also say that the result of this would be very similar to B1, which is really what we want. We again can do that for every column of B. And again, we can recognize that this is just the same matrix multiplying each of the individual columns of the picture, and therefore we can pull that out. And then we can reconstruct this to be matrix B. And we get this expression right here. Now, before, this turned out to be just one vector, because matrix A consisted of only one column. Let's check our dimensions. A transpose A is going to be 2 by 2 because A has two columns. And then you multiply that times a matrix that is 2 by M because A is M by 2. So if you transpose it, then you get a 2 by M matrix. And that then multiplies a matrix that's M by N. So the net result of that is going to be a matrix that's 2 by N. In size. So Y transpose is 2 by N. So A is two columns, and Y transpose is two rows. Or you can say A is two columns, and Y transpose is two columns transposed. And that's what we summarize right here. Now, you all have learned how to multiply with partitioned matrices. So you recognize that this is this times that plus that times that. And that shows that you can also think of this approximation as adding two rank one matrices together. Or you're adding two outer products together. Or you're doing a rank one update to an outer product. Those are all the same thing. So if we do that with our picture, we get this right here. You may actually recognize that picture. So in summary, if you start with a matrix B and a matrix A, you can create an approximation for matrix B by projecting each of the columns of B onto the space spanned by the columns of A. This yields an approximation that looks like that, where each column of Y then tells you how to take linear combinations of the columns of A to approximate the column of B. And that matrix is just the transpose of what we just used in our approximation in the previous slide, which can then be written as such. Each column of A times Y transpose equals the projection of the corresponding column of B onto the column space of A. If we only have two columns in A, then this is known as a rank 2 approximation of B. Now, this is not necessarily the best rank 2 approximation. It's the best rank 2 approximation if you restrict your matrix A to have the given columns with which you start.